As you know, I have already featured quite good numbers of masks on my channel. For example, the KF94 mask, which is very popular in Korea. And also the block shield. I don't think this should be called a mask because it doesn't really protect on the edge where it doesn't touch the surface of your face. So I think it's purely for the splash proof and it also looks very cool. Also, I have featured AustAir 2 or 3 times already and it looks really cool. It works really well. It's very comfortable. The only downside I would say is that it's not invisible, so someone cannot see whether you're laughing. I guess they could guess by the expression of your eye, but you can't really see the expression inside the mask. While as this one is the MOD S2 mask, the downside of this one is that the strap, the way how it's joined, even though it looks cool, in the long term it's not really that comfortable. So I wish they could come up with the ear loop design, and I think that would be a much improvement. But overall, the usage of a mask, I think the reason why people don't like to wear a mask is that it hides your expression, while as if you do wear a mask, it tends to be not that comfortable for all the people, if you see what I mean. So I think if it was to be transparent, that has an ear loop sort of design, and I think that would be really, really good. And that's exactly what we have here. This is the purMe mask that I asked for, the invisible one that is available on Indiegogo at the moment for crowdfunding. And quite rightly, we have seen on CES 2021 this year, mask has been one of the most main feature, and it's very important tech that you know, techie guys like myself should feature. So let's get into details. So here it goes. So this has already reached more than £400,000, and it's almost on the shipping stage. So it comes with 3 different colors: black, white, and see-through transparent. And I got the transparent here. And the way how it works is very interesting, actually. The air comes in one filter and then goes out to the other. I don't know how that would feel, but I'm very excited to find out how it will. Now, the way how it's structured, that I want to explain, is that it has a splash cap, obviously, and then the air comes in through an N95 particle filter. Then it goes through the inhale valve, and then it goes out through the strap ring and pod base, and then exhale valve. So the main thing that features out all the dirt and the particles is the N95 particle filter that you need to order once it actually, you know, expires. The box comes in, and then we got the purMe, and then pretty simple, straightforward. Right, so I can already feel the silicone cushion and all the certificate as well. purMe. And then this is the instruction, so please do check it out. Pause. Okay. And then I guess this will actually show the way how we actually place it. Please pause and have a look. All right. So what else are inside is the... That's the filter. So let's see how many we got. We've got good numbers of filters, actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 10 already there. Ah, actually, there's another 10 filter inside as well. So we've got 20 filters. That's really good. And then if we were to take this out, sorry about the ruthlessness, but okay. So this is all in silicone, thin silicone seal. So let's take out the mask itself first. Nice, look at that. That's very soft, jelly-like main mask. And then what we have after that is okay, that's good. Just a transparent cap. And then these are the exhale inhale valve, and that is, I believe, one of the bits that you fit in to the filter. And lastly, so those are the ear loop Alright, so the assembly should be pretty straightforward, hopefully. So you take this out, and the blue is for the inhale, and that needs to be back of this. Alright, so that's fit in. So the other side of it is that this needs to go inside to inside out, okay? So this is for the exhale, so make sure you push it right in, and that's in. Great. Alright, so I guess you got a bit, basically make sure this fits in right into the silicone base. Okay, make sure it's tightly sealed. It is actually designed so that it will fit perfectly well, and make sure you do the same for the other one as well. So that should wrap up the edge where all the silicone is actually placed. And then what you need to do is, on the blue one, you need to put in the filter, KF95 filter, inside here. But before that, also make sure you put the, this is the strap ring. And when you put in the strap, make sure it's actually following the shape of your ear. We all know that, right? And the next one is the other filter, KF95 filter, that needs to also go inside the other side as well, I presume. And then put in the strap ring, and then seal it off. Okay? That's all good to go. Now, before we get into the fitting, this is purely is for the P100. It's actually on the directions here that that's a special cap for this one. So unfortunately, I'm not going to cover that one, but for this side, it's all good to go. Right, the moment of truth, let's try it on. So you make sure this shape actually fits into your ear, and then there's this mag lock that you fit on the back onto the other end, okay? So that's how you fit it. Yep, there you go. Okay. I'm finding it a bit difficult to exhale. Inhale is not a problem at all. But before we actually make any changes to the configuration, let's try out the fog test on this one. Yeah, that's very good, because the air comes in this way and exhale that way. There's no chance of the air coming in, because you can see that the silicone itself is actually folded inwards. It's a really clever design. I like it. But let's actually take out the filter on the exhaled side, because I know it's a bit selfish of me to do that, but on the manual, it actually does show on the assembly manual that you're only putting in the filter on the inhale. So let's take out the exhale to see how well breathable it is, and also the fog test at the same time. That's much better. So you can see and hear the sound when you inhale, the exhale block is blocked, and that click sound, that's really clever mechanism there. The only thing I would say is that it's transparent. You can see me smiling, actually. Hey,
hey, how's it going?
But the only downside I would say is that if you're trying to have a communication with someone, it'll be very difficult. You have to probably lean into someone really closely, but then again, we have to keep that distance, social distance at the moment. So for the current circumstances, it suits, but if you want to communicate with someone, it's not ideal, but then again, do you need to? That's the question I want to ask you. But yeah, that's really good. It's very comfortable. It's very comfortable on your ears, and also the ring itself, it moves around, and magnetic joint is very secure. And yeah, since I got the filter out on the exhale, it's much better to breathe. And it's also transparent as well. and silicone, very flexible, so it fits right into your face. And also the fog test is number one at the moment, so I'm really pleased with it. But if you have any queries regards to this mask, if you're not sure of any certain things that you want me to try out, please do comment below, and I hope this video clarifies what this purMe mask is all about. So thank you very much for watching this video. This is LJP Tech. All the best. Bye bye.